Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have the absolute pleasure of showcasing for you the brand new, as of recording this video, MXR Joshua Delay in all of its glory. Let's get into it. With this pedal, MXR have done what they do best. George Trips and his gang of merry men have came together and taken something iconic, which is like an iconic old school vintage rack mount delay used on so many famous records, and it's like that iconic ambient delay tone with a bit of reverb modulation sprinkled in. They've taken that, simplified it, made it very small, but kept all the juice and all the loveliness and put it in an enclosure no bigger than a Phase 90. It's an incredible little thing. Now, it is an ambient echo, as you can see. I'm not the most ambient guitar player in the world, and I'm guessing a lot of videos on this pedal will be, you know, the whole... that kind of thing, and I will be doing some of that in this video, but I just want to show that it's not just for that. It's a wonderful delay regardless. It's in the effects loop of the St. James right now. Mix it quite high there, but there's way more to this than just a repeat after the note you've played. It's way more than just a standard. I've got the reverb turned off on the amplifier, so the amp is very dry. You can feel it under your fingertips. It's just a very, very special little pedal. So if you notice, there's a lot more than just a single delay sound happening there. Obviously, there is a delay sound. But so much more than just that one delay. It's got that rich, like, atmospheric texture to it. Get, obviously, soundscape stuff all the way through to trippy 60s stuff, surf stuff, and everything in between. So besides the delay I was talking about, there's two delays built into it. Two delays rocking at once. You'll also hear some modulation in there and some octaves kicking about as well. Let's show you how to work this wonderful little beast. Now off the bat, I am going to say everything on the front of this does two things. There's a secondary function for a lot of this. I'll talk about that more in a second. Like I've just said, little button up top here, echo 2, turns on the second echo. So you've got your regular delay sound. This little guy up here adds a second delay sound, as if it's turning on another delay pedal in that signal chain. It's a quarter note at the minute behind it. Hear that? Trails on the right-hand side here is simple. That just turns the trails on and off when you turn the pedal on and off, so... keeps it going. Kills it completely, that's what trails do. Now the knobs themselves do kind of do what they say on the tin. Up top you've got the delay, which is pretty much how fast or slow do you want your delay. In the middle you've got modulation. This is in charge of the lush, what's it, the texture. I'm using texture modulation inside the Joshua delay. Thank you. get a bit crazy if you want by tick right cranking it. The voice control to the right of the modulation control is pretty interesting. That actually adds in either an octave up, two octaves up, or an octave down to the trails. Funky uncharted territory right there. The regen down below is pretty much how many repeats you want after the note you play. Doing a lot. Well, not a lot. You have the division in the middle, which is the tap division, which chooses the rhythm in which the delays are played after you play your initial note. So like a quarter note, an eighth, a dotted eighth, all that kind of thing. Yeah, so you have fun with it that way. And the mix to the right-hand side just controls how much of the delayed signal you want affecting your original signal. So you can either have it subtly in the signal, or quite intensely. Over halfway, it starts to become more delayed tone, like more wet than dry. So the delayed tone's actually stronger than the initial tone. So much fun. At the side of it as well, you'll notice a little input with a little switch. That is for an external either tap tempo foot switch, depending on where the little switch is set, so you can change the tempo on the fly on your pedal board, or an expression pedal. Now this works the same as the M300 reverb pedal from MXR, where you can alter any of the parameters with the expression pedal. Put the expression pedal forward, change all the parameters, and it'll save that sweep. Either do it subtly with one control, or change them all if you like. With regards to the secondary functions, you can alter their parameters by holding down either the second echo button or the trails button and changing any of these controls. I'll be here all day if I go through them in depth, so if you pause the screen in a second, you can see what they all do right here. So those specs right there, obviously you can read that, and if I demoed it all, this video will be an hour and a half long. If you want to get involved with that and go in depth yourself, you've got to get yourself to your local PMT store and try one of these out for yourself. The whole point of this video is to hear it, that's why you're watching it. Okay, the modulation can get pretty crazy if you wanted to. Someone is gonna make that sound great, but it's not my, I don't think I can. It's not my style of playing. Called it Joshua, man. Come on. So that's the octave down. Ladies and gents, that's all the sight specs and sounds I can give you from the absolutely fabulous MXR Joshua Ambient Echo. Let me know what you think down below in the comments, and if you want to get on for yourself, there's a link down there which will take you to PMTOnline.co.uk in the description box. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and hit subscribe. We are playing music today on all social media platforms. You'll find me at Dagan on Instagram. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.